Okay, we're taking a ride over to the park today. I'm going to take some pictures of the bicycle to put up on YouTube. So that's what we're up to. A YouTube tour of this old man's fat bike. Kind of a day of a mix of sun and clouds. I have never ridden the bike to this park. Checking both ways and crossing. Not enter. Use Point Nav entrance. Oh, that sucks. This is a little hill here. I may need to get off this bike and walk it. And taking Point Nav, which is kind of a high speed, heavy traffic route, that may not be too safe. I don't know. I don't think there's a sidewalk. Maybe there is. I don't think there's any way to get out of traffic over there. Maybe I can just cut through these trees here and ride in. I don't know. We'll see. Hey, it is a Monday, a sunny Monday so far, but it is getting a little overcast. Nope, no way through the trees, they have a fence. Lots of cars and kids in there. With their moms and enjoying the recreation activities. That high rise up ahead with all the cell towers on it, all the cell transmitters, that's one of the old age folks' homes here in town. I was correct, there is no sidewalk. Oh yes, there is a sidewalk. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Finally a sidewalk. Okay. I'll take your sidewalk and raise you two dirt roads. There is no sidewalk down further. This is a nice little park. An area for skateboards. See, I could have cut in that little road right there. If they'd let you, it would be nice. Trying to look for a good paved area where I can set the bike down. Yeah, dog park. Ooh, dog do. Nope. Not going there. Well, I guess we'll do it right up here at the end of the driveway. Let's get some pictures of the big old mongoose beast for you. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a cell phone, get the shots. I still have the helmet cam on. It's a little noisy out here right now. Okay. So I'm gonna walk over here and line up on the beast over there. And we'll start getting some video for you. There it goes, it's recording. So that's the mongoose beast. Right there. There is a mongoose beast. Now that's what I'm riding. So when I am making these videos, you can see what I'm riding. If people say it has big tires on it, you can see why. It was one of these things we got from Walmart that never shipped. And so finally they ended up putting it in FedEx overnight air. And it was here in 2 days, but it was hard to get it. A few modifications I've done. Obviously, we painted the white rims black, both the front and the rear tire. So that's cool. Another modification that I love, this is a cheap Bell rear rack available at Walmart. And what you do is, if you take the legs that go down to the seat stays, if you take those from the rear wheel stay and move them to the outside instead of the inside where they give them to you made up as, move them to the outside, and you'll be able to get a rear rack that has enough clearance so you can ride this thing. It's probably got about 3/8 to a half inch of clearance on the back of the bike and on the front of the rack. And then the other thing I had to do was take some strip metal and just kind of make a little modification to hold the rack onto the bike. You can see it here. There's one bolt that holds it on right down in there, right to the frame of the bike, and then it comes up and attaches. Also the bottoms, let me go around to the other side. At the base, I also use some of that metal stripping to bring it up about 4 holes and give it a little more height to the rear rack stays and to kind of bring them out a bit. It naturally wants to settle down and settle out when you have a load on it, so that's cool. And it makes it just a hair wider. So there it is. That's a rear rack, cheap one. It's a Bell rear rack available at Walmart. Now the other modification I made was the saddle. This is an End Zone saddle I picked up on eBay. The little taillight was a Walmart purchase. You get a headlight and a taillight, I think, for about 20 bucks. You can see them in there. But those are also bikes in the bike department at Walmart. These pedals I'm not too cool with, but that's what I got. Up here at the front, I have a rear view mirror, a little tiny one, but it's enough. And you can kind of see if there's any traffic coming at you or anything. and working your way across, you will see a camera mount. That's a small camera mount, and then a tablet mount, which holds the tablet that operates the camera that I have on my helmet. And I can actually see the picture that I'm getting with a camera helmet, the helmet cam in the tablet. And of course, a little compass and a bell. There, little bell. That's about it. It's not that great. There is a bag, a little bag I got for $5 on eBay on the handlebars in the front. And there, I also have a spare battery in that on one side. And I can use that to help power the tablet above it, so I'll never run out of power for that when I'm on a ride. Well, that's about it. Oh yeah, I did take a bell sticker that came with the helmet I wear, and I put that on the front of it. I don't know why, because it was there. But we took all the decals off of it, and that's what we got. So that's what the bike looks like. And you can see why it probably freaks some people out when they're not expecting to see big, large tires like that. But it's a fun bike to ride. It'll really make you work. You get your exercise, and that's why I got it. It's real cheap. You can buy it for $200 or less through Walmart online. And like I say, it's a cheap, cheap bike. Another couple things I did. I added a few more pieces of chain to the sprocket chain. And the rear sprocket that comes with this is an 18 tooth, and it's a little too hard to pedal, so I put on a 21 tooth, and that's what I'm running now. I also have a 23 tooth if I get too old to ride on the 21 tooth, but I think it's okay. So that's a 21 tooth sprocket on there. I want to thank all the people here on YouTube that have shared their Mongoose Beast bicycles, especially a fellow called V-Dub Bugs out in Arizona, and a fellow who goes by the moniker of Loco Joe. His name is Randy. He's out in the upper north Midwest or somewhere. So anyways, thank you guys for helping me discover a bike that is just right for this big fat old guy. Mongoose Beast, everybody. Enjoy the video. We'll catch you next time.
This recording. So that's the Mongoose Beast right there. There is a Mongoose Beast. Now that's what I'm riding. So when I am making these videos, you see what I'm riding.
Is he able to cut through?
It has big tires on it. You can see why. It was one of these things we got from Walmart that never shipped until finally they ended up putting it in the FedEx overnight air, and it was here in 2 days, but it was hard to get it. A few modifications I've done. Obviously, we painted the white rims black.
Okay, all right, where can I get off of here on? Over there. There I go. That guy just rides right up there. What can I? Looks like a guy just rode his bike right out this little road that said I couldn't come in. So we'll go see if maybe we can come in there. Big old city lawnmower up here. I think I'll just ride around the park a little bit and see what it's got going for it here. It's a little rough out here. Boom, 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 bounce, bounce, bounce. I don't know where this path goes to. Plattsburgh Community Garden looks like fun. I think I'll go in there and make a feature on it someday. Yeah, lots of places to ride back here. That's pretty cool. Lots of broken up pavement out here. Okay, I know where we are. We're back where we started. One noisy lawnmower. It seems like I didn't have to pedal myself up that hill and around to the front end of that park. Seems like I could have just driven in the back end and been right there. Oh well, older and wiser. The sign saying no entrance to use the entrance on the other street, though, is what threw me off. I was trying to be a good law-abiding citizen, and that sign's pretty ambiguous as to what its true meaning is. If you're watching on YouTube, I guess we'll have to say goodbye to you if I even put this video on YouTube. Hope you all have a great week. And see you for the next big old bicycle ride.